I think we'll have a very popular choice, whoever it may be, but we'll be sending it over to the Senate. I think the choice will be next week. Yes.
I have opinions. I'm Danielle Young, journalist, content queen, host, and I'm opinionated. This is a commentary and explainer series that explores Black life, Black culture, and Black stories and makes them plain, point blank, and the period poo. Y'all know we be keeping the poo. And on this episode, we're getting into Ruth Bader Ginsburg's legacy and what we stand to lose if we don't build on it. RBG used her career in law and as Supreme Court Justice to disrupt and shatter the patriarchy that this country was built on. Equal rights for women was her focus, and her work has changed laws that have allowed women basic human rights. So losing her is losing a lot. RBG hasn't even been gone a week, and already your boy Trump is in a rush to fill her seat, which is hilarious considering, like, back when Justice Scalia died 9 months before the 2016 election, the GOP blocked Obama from appointing a new justice. They said since it was so close to the election that it should be for the next president to decide. So why y'all in a rush now? The court is supposed to be politically neutral. However, we are very aware that now, without RBG in her seat, it's systematically racist politics as usual. RBG wanted and fought for equality. And with someone like Trump getting to replace someone like RBG, it's just not looking good for us, y'all. The Supreme Court tends to do most of their business in private, you know, no cameras around, nothing like that. And, whew, child, that's another thing for another day. We gonna talk about that though. Y'all, Trump has already gotten to appoint two other Supreme Court justices, Neil Gorsuch and Brett Kavanaugh. Great picks, Trump. And now, Trump's about to get to pick a third Supreme Court justice in his presidency. These are positions that people hold for life, forever and ever, amen. But in case you're not keeping count, Trump has been appointing some other people. He has nominated and confirmed 44 circuit court judges and 112 whole district court judges, all chosen by Trump. And leaving it up to Donald Trump to pick anything is just stressing out me and my homegirls. Lord Jesus, help us all. There's many Black women who are qualified to fill that seat, even though Trump would never. There's Justice Leandra Kruger, the second Black woman to serve on the California Supreme Court. Sherrilyn Ifill, current president and director counsel of the NAACP Legal Defense and Educational Fund, which is the LDF, and they fight for racial justice and equality, kind of stuff we be needing on the Supreme Court. There's Judge Ketanji Brown Jackson, who was on Obama's shortlist to replace Justice Scalia. Judge Jackson is a former appellate lawyer from the private sector. I don't know what that means, but it sounds important. She was a federal public defender who handled appeals. She was a clerk to Associate Justice of the Supreme Court Stephen Breyer, a staff lawyer, and later Obama appointed member of the U.S. Sentencing Commission. She got a resume, honey, and there's even more Black women who are more than qualified to fill that seat. We deserve lawmakers who reflect the society that they're creating laws for. I'm not saying that Black women can and will save the day, because, like, we do all the time. But look at all Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg was able to do to shift history and create equality where there was none. Rest in peace, RBG. Her legacy is ours to build on, and we owe it to her to continue pushing against this racist and sexist status quo.